Hello and welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. In this video, we're going to cover how to use the empirical rule for normal distributions. Now, first we should talk just a little bit about what this actually says, and then we'll get into a couple of examples on how to use it. So the empirical rule just gives us how much of our data lies within 1, 2, or 3 standard deviations of the mean. So visually, if you want to take a look at this, you know, in the center of each of these normal distributions, I have the mean. And then we're looking at 1 standard deviation of either side, 2 standard deviations of either side, or 3 standard deviations of either side. And what the empirical rule says is that we could expect 68% of our data to be within 1 standard deviation, 95% of our data to be within 2 standard deviations, and 99.7% to be within 3 standard deviations. So it's just really just a wonderful rule to tell us how much of our data we can expect to be around our mean. All right, let's get into some examples and see how this might work. For the first example, we're going to look at grades for a certain history exam. And we're given that they follow a normal distribution. That's important because this empirical rule works for normal distributions. Looks like we have a mean of 78 and a standard deviation of 6. So our goal is to find the range of values around the mean that include 95% of the grades. So just as a quick thing to get started, it's a good idea to identify key bits of information like the mean and the standard deviations. Well, let's go ahead and just write those down. So our mean is 78, and our standard deviation is 6. Now we're looking for the range around the mean, which includes 95% of the grades. If we recall back to what I just said about the empirical rule, 95% around the mean, that corresponds to 2 standard deviations on either side of our mean. So what we really need to do is just take our mean, and if we're going to look for that range, we'll either add or subtract 2 standard deviations around it. All right, let's get that bottom range first. So our mean is 78. We will subtract 2 standard deviations, or 2 times 6. So that'll be 78 minus 12. So our lower number is 66. To get the upper number, almost identical, 78. Now we're adding 2 standard deviations, or plus 2 times 6, so that's 78 plus 12, and that'll give us 90. All right, so putting it all together, this tells us that grades between 66 and 90, that if I have grades between 66 and 90, that'll capture 95% of all the grades. Now, this is just an approximate value. You know, if you were looking at real data, it might not be exactly 95%, but it's probably going to be pretty close. All right, let's look at one more example. In this example, we're looking at the heights of women, and it looks like they follow a bell-shaped distribution. Remember, that's just another way of saying that this is a normal distribution. Looks like it has a mean of 160 centimeters and a standard deviation of 7.5. It looks like we want to know what is the approximate percentage of women between 137.5 centimeters and 182.5 centimeters. All right, so like before, again, always a good idea, identify what the mean and standard deviation is when you're given that information, especially for bell-shaped or normal distributions. So we have a mean of 160 centimeters, standard deviation of 7.5 centimeters. All right, and we're given a range, and we're kind of backtracking, trying to figure out what that percentage is. Well, since this is a bell-shaped distribution, normal distribution, we're still going to think of the mean and either add or subtract some number of standard deviations and connect that into our range. All right, so let's see. Let's go ahead and borrow the upper range, because that will allow us to figure out how many standard deviations we are away. So that's the mean, 160. We don't know how many standard deviations we are, so we'll just leave that as k. And we'll multiply that by the standard deviation of 7.5. And since we're adding, this should equal the upper number, the 182.5. All right, now we just need to solve this for k and see how many standard deviations that is. We'll start that by subtracting the 160 from both sides. No problem, that'll give us 22.5. And then we can divide both sides of this by 7.5. That will give us that k is equal to 3. Perfect. So there's 3 standard deviations to reach that upper range. All right, so thinking back to the empirical rule, here's where we can use it. 99.7%, that corresponds to 3 standard deviations. Nice. So what does this really tell us? What is the approximate percentage of women between these two values? Well, according to the empirical rule, it's 99.7%. And again, that might not be exact, but it is a really good approximation. All right, hopefully that helped you out understand more about the empirical rule. If you'd like to see more of my videos, please visit MySecretMathTutor.com.